Today on DNews, we're going to talk about hot sex. Greetings, people I tricked with the cold open. Julian here for DNews. Something odd is happening with central bearded dragons in Australia. Suddenly, there's a lot more lady dragons running around, and they're bigger, bolder, and laying more eggs. They're also genetically identical to the males. It turns out the sex of bearded dragons isn't necessarily determined by their chromosomes. It can also be determined by the temperature. If an embryo with a male genetic makeup is incubated at a certain temperature at a certain stage of development, it'll be born a fully functioning female. This is actually surprisingly common. The male to female ratios of many reptiles are influenced by temperature, including most turtles and all crocodilians. Even some fish have temperature-dependent sexual development. Usually for turtles, eggs incubated at lower temperatures, say from 22 to 27 degrees Celsius, all become males, and eggs incubated at higher temperatures, over 30 degrees Celsius, all become females. If the eggs are incubated at the sweet spot of 28.5 Celsius, the ratio will be 50-50. Crocodilian species, like the American alligator, become female if the temperature is low or high, and the males are spawned at the temperature in between. Species like this don't have heteromorphic sex chromosomes like we do. Temperature is everything. How exactly temperature determines sex remains a mystery. It appears to have an impact on aromatase, an enzyme that converts testosterone to estrogen. Whether temperature directly affects aromatase, the gene that makes it, or the proteins that regulate it, remains to be discovered. But for reptiles like the bearded dragon, it's a mix of both the chromosomes they inherit and the temperature they are incubated at. This may sound odd because you're probably used to thinking that two X chromosomes make a lady and an X and a Y chromosome make a guy. Not so for the bearded dragon. First off, instead of X and Y chromosomes, they have what are called Z and W chromosomes. If an unborn bearded dragon has a Z and a W chromosome, no matter what the temperature, it will always be female. But if it's homogametic, if it has two Z chromosomes, then it could be born male or female. Of course, male, female, or male, female, they all still get beards. Anyway, double Z females are on the rise, and the shift is a cause for concern. If they outcompete the heterogametic females because they're more aggressive and lay more eggs, it'll cause a massive loss of genetic diversity after just a couple generations. Then, if temperatures continue to rise, it may lead to all-female populations, and if that happens too fast, life, probably won't find a way. Just like a good party, a balanced male-to-female ratio is crucial for the success of most species. Basically, if you want to be the mother of dragons, we have to stop climate change. Man, that climate change stuff is the worst. Mother Nature is one creative lady when it comes to all the different ways sex can be expressed, like with flatworms and clownfish. It's awesome. Check it out here. You see, most flatworms are hermaphroditic, meaning they have male and female sex organs. Some large aquatic species of flatworm actually mate with a behavior called penis fencing. It's exactly what it sounds like. Winner gets laid, loser gets stabbed and pregnant. Is saving turtles enough motivation to take action against climate change? Tell us in the comments section down below. Don't forget to click subscribe for new episodes every day, and I will see you next time on DNews.